Exercises that emphasize the weighted stretch tend to be really good mass builders. That's why in today's video, I'll discuss what those movements are for each body part. Let's get started. For the back, I can think of no better movement than the weighted pull-up. This is literally stretching yourself into having bigger wings. Regardless of the range of motion, whether your chin is above the bar or chest simply touching, doesn't matter. The eccentric loading factor is present. When you get to the bottom, you really feel the stretch. And that's what makes a difference, lengthening out that body, full range of motion. I'll have to be shrugged up here, but at least do the exercise properly. Partials are not what I recommend for this, unless using a wider grip, and we're talking about the concentric, where your eyes are even with the bar, but not the bottom portion. So make sure to use good form, and as long as you're getting stronger over time, there should be no difficulties in developing the V taper. When I see guys repping three plates in the pull-ups, it shows in their physiques. And let me tell you, that is a realistic achievement. I can't tell you how many subscribers reported that exact amount. 135 for reps. Let's go. You can do it too. Instead of wasting your time with a lot of the fluff out there, even bodybuilders will tell you that pull-ups are absolutely key. Doesn't matter who you are, an athlete or someone who emphasizes hypertrophy training, this will get the job done. And I can tell you that the time periods where I did nothing but pull-ups, I still got bigger and stronger. And the carryover to deadlifts was amazing as well. My rows did not suffer for this. But of course, I believe in maximized programming, and I learned a long time ago that you can't just skip out the horizontal pulls. So what do I recommend for this? Got a lot of choices, but I would say the dumbbell row is an excellent weighted stretching tool. Why? The unilateral factor makes it such that we can actually increase the range of motion a bit further. We're reaching, in other words. Remember, the form is not black and white. Yeah, with the concentric, if you bring it a bit higher up, might smash a rhomboid a bit harder. If you bring it towards your hip, maybe a bit more lat. And the same goes for the eccentric. You can keep your body a bit more stationary, or you can protract to the bottom, really get a deeper stretch. And that's what I recommend if you want to maximize your size gains, as long as you're not using terrible form. But do keep in mind, cheat rows kind of perform that feat. But I recommend doing it in a controlled fashion, kind of replacing the word cheat with power. Because when reps become extremely sloppy, it's not the same muscle building effect. But I still can't deny the weighted stretching benefits. And the cheat form with dumbbell rows is very different compared to the barbell row, where you might bring the bar on your body, but you're actually cutting range of motion or actually elevating your torso constantly. At least with this version, we're brace. We got one arm down, torso remains in a relatively stable position. It might elevate a little bit, but it's pretty bent forward. So it looks cleaner than other forms. Now, at least the strength curve is fine. You can still hold at the top, get a nice squeeze in, and then the eccentric is just stretched out to the absolute max. So I highly recommend this, not only for athletic benefits, because this will give you carryover to many sports, but for pure bodybuilding gains. This is definitely a banger. You can go back and forth, left arm, right arm, doing reps of 10 to 20. If you're maxing out the dumbbell stack, honestly, you're probably covered. Okay, so now let's talk about the pecs. Some of the best movements you could do are calisthenics based. And in this case, I'm talking about weighted dips. Guys who get strong at this, if you can rep out 4 or 5 plates, you're gonna have watermelons popping out almost every single time. It really does test your strength in a strict manner. You're moving through space, again, like the pull-ups, with a range of motion that exceeds most of the presses that we typically do. And that's why some guys get shoulder pain, by the way, or even rib pain. So if you're one of those people, maybe shy away from this or try to experiment with a form style that works for you. I definitely recommend you check out my video, The Weighted Dip Solution, because I do give you some options there. But this is getting the job done. Just think about the bench press and what happens when the barbell is brought to your chest. You feel that stretch, do you not? Well, guess what? The dips further extend that position. So you're really maximizing the effect here. And when you pause on top of it, you're getting an isometric stretch overload. This is the real deal. Much better than the pause bench, in my opinion. But again, it's hard on recovery and heavy weights can be utilized. So maybe don't do these all the time, or if you do, perform higher reps instead. It's gonna help your bench press and overhead press alike, while getting you insanely jacked in the process. And if you did nothing but this, you'd already be huge. Just that, you need to hit some other areas to prevent imbalances and make sure that everything is feeling right. Now, another exercise that complements this would be the deficit push-up, either weighted or just regular version. I like doing these for burnouts at the end of a routine, or if you're doing a calisthenics focused workout, higher reps or low rest intervals. So if dips do bother you a bit, this would be the next best thing. But do keep in mind, the overloading factor is not really the best when you're doing it weighted, because it's an awkward setup and most of you don't have the appropriate box heights to do it in a way where bigger plates can be incorporated. Like over here, it's a hard setup for the most part. So that's the only limitation. You're probably gonna have to do some higher reps, which there's honestly nothing wrong about that. You see me do 30 down push-up workouts. So if you're able to make gains with body weight only, then surely you don't have to go excessively heavy on the weighted push-up. So it doesn't have to become your main build, although it certainly can if you have the right setup and everything. And it obviously it's suitable for your strength level, but understand that's a great choice regardless. And I definitely recommend these two movements as opposed to a chest fly, because you're not really getting a better way to stretch. When you're in that maxed out position and you have your arm out, it's more pressure on the AC joint. And this little tie-in right here, that's not more isolating the outer pec, okay? That's complete bro science. The real benefit of the fly is the fact that we can take our chest to failure, which can allow us to get more or less weight if we're using it as a pre-exhaust tool, or just we have a lagging chest in general. Plus, we can bring the arm across the body so we get the squeeze. It's a peak contraction based lift, and I don't recommend doing it with dumbbells. It's definitely superior with cables, in my honest opinion. So that's what I see it being valuable for, especially for those who are arm dominant. But in terms of pure weighted stretch, how do you want to compete with a weighted dip? Okay, so now let's talk about the traps. Any deadlift variation will suit you fine. It doesn't really matter. We're not shrugging. You're just pulling, and the weight happens to be stretching out your traps, which develops them over time. Whether you choose to do more of a partial position or deficit full range, it's up to you. I personally prefer a bit of elevation. This way, the posterior chain is not as much of a limiting factor, and we can really focus on those higher reps specifically, which is probably better in the long run. But choose a style that fits you most. But if you want to get the best out of every world, just do deadlifts with accommodating resistance. This way, you don't have to worry about anything. You're getting the carryover, you're getting the athletic benefits, but we're really maximizing the weight of stretch overload. The top is going to be heavier. So a deadlift with bands, out of this world, and deadlift with chains, same thing. So you don't necessarily have to split up the range of motion aspect, though I do recommend that if you're incorporating progressive range of motion. So any pull will do you fine. And so are farmer walks incredibly effective. It's the same mechanism. You're just walking with a heavy weight, you're being stretched out. It is what it is, man. And since we're talking about the yoke, you might be asking, what about the neck? Listen, it's very simple. You want to do the neck curl. Either the plate version, so you're lying down on the bench, which is feasible for a lot of you guys watching this video, or with a neck harness, though I don't like the straight weight version for this. I feel like it puts more pressure in the wrong way. So the angle in which you do the curl is very important, and lying down on that bench is certainly a great position to be in, or simply standing up, but having a harness with bands. Now, I consider that to be much more effective than sitting down with a chain kind of upside down, and you're stretching out this way. Because even when you get to the curling part, the resistance profile is not what you think it is. I recommend having the position either above you or slightly below at an angle. So you're kind of curling diagonally. Anyway, let's go over shoulders very briefly, and I'll keep it real. I had a hard time coming up with an exercise. So I'm gonna refer you to the rear delt swing, which was popularized by John Meadows. And let me say that he can explain it and demonstrate it much better than I can. I don't really do this in my training. I certainly recommend it, and I'm aware of its benefits, but it's not something that I consistently perform. I much prefer the standard rear delt fly. I feel like I get a better mind-muscle connection, if you will. And I still get to go to failure without going very heavy. And I like the increased range of motion, but hey, we're talking about weighted stretch, right? Rear delt swings. Give them a shot. Again, check out John Meadows' channel. He actually got really popular on YouTube, man. It's crazy, because years back, he wasn't in this scene, but now he's all in it, and he's giving some really good bodybuilding content. So check him out, all right? So moving forward, let me cover the legs with the exception of calves, since most of us don't even train them, and then I'll finalize this video with the arms. So, posterior chain, I definitely recommend the Romanian deadlift or the Good Morning, even including both, to be honest with you. This will blow up your glutes and hamstrings. You are literally stretching yourself in that deep position. Right before you're about to hit the ground, you come back up. In a way, you can't really call them deadlifts in a sense. Like, they're eccentric-based hip hinge exercises that allow us to get lots of volume in. Sure, you're not going as heavy, but you can do more quality reps. And there is that deep stretching component, which is very helpful in gaining mass, as I've shown in this video so far. So you really can't go wrong with that. For the RDLs, it can be done with a barbell or a dumbbell on the Good Morning. Experiment with different stances, you know. I love the standard version with a safety squat bar on my back. It just feels the most comfortable, and I feel like the leverages are amazing. So for those, just make sure not to go excessively heavy right off the bat. Start with a lightweight, maybe even empty bar, work your way up. Understand that the weights used will be a fraction of your RDL weights. So the RDL, you can obviously lift a lot more, but do keep in mind, it's harder on your recovery and not because the muscles, it's the leverages involved. Now for the quads, it could be a little bit tricky, but let me first say that most of the squatting variations you do are absolutely sufficient for building up those quads. The stretch is enough, but if you want a little bit more emphasis, this is what I could potentially recommend. Two exercises, one being the Vince Gironda hack squat. This is where you go in the hack squat machine, but you form a frog stance. So on the balls of your feet, legs completely flared out, and squat all the way down. It's an old school exercise that not many people know about, but it really is effective at stretching out and burning that quad to the absolute max. So you're probably gonna like the muscle building effects, and there's no pressure on the lower back. But please understand that this and many other movements that induce a stretch on the quads can be damaging to the knees. I don't think it's the best exercise for your structural integrity. You have to factor in risk versus reward here. Is it worth for you? It might be, I don't know. Do I see myself doing that exercise? Probably not. I think I'll be just fine doing belt squats and traditional acid grass squats. But again, you want a bit more of that stretch? Try this out, you might really like it. Now another exercise that complements this, also old school, and again, I don't know if I could really recommend this, would be the sissy squat. This stretches your quads, and most people can't even do 20 reps in a row without any weights, unassisted. It's actually a difficult bodyweight exercise. So you're squatting on the balls of your feet, going all the way down, extending. That knee goes all the way forward, and you come back up. And hey, if you're too weak to do that right now, just grab onto a power rack or anything stationary, you'll be good to go. This is exceptional. And after doing 3 to 5 sets, you're gonna have trouble walking, guaranteed. But I would recommend doing this at the end of your workout if you plan on including them at all. So at the final part of this video, the arms. For biceps, I can think of no better lift than the incline dumbbell curl. Whether you're doing two arms at a time or one, it's all good. What you have is a stretch reflex-based exercise. You get to the bottom and boom, it's as if your bicep is about to be torn off. That is the sensation you're gonna get. So please start off with lighter weights. You might wanna begin with 15, 20 pounds max and work your way up, because you do need some tendon strength to get in that deep position. And if you want more of a stretch, you can put your head more back on that incline bench. But this is probably not necessary. Like, it depends who you listen to. Some guys are gonna say you wanna be completely stationary, pin back, and just curl, right? Other guys are gonna say, don't worry about the head so much, just make sure that you are at an incline angle. At the end of the day, if you're getting the stretch, you're getting the stretch, right? So there's different degrees of strictness. I just say do what feels best and safest, all right? And you'll know what that is for you. Like, I know for me, I have hypermobile elbows, and when I put my head back, that sensation is further exaggerated, which may actually be good for muscle hypertrophy, but I don't know about the safety aspect, so I prefer having my head a little bit more neutral. But again, you do what you want regarding that. And if you want another whirl that's really gonna build those biceps through weighted stretch, look into gymnastic rings. Most of the exercise that involve the RTO position, rings turn out, will blow up those biceps, let me tell you. The pump is gonna be out of this world, and it really humbles you. I don't care if you're doing dips. I don't care if you're doing a more specific exercise. Rings work your biceps. And that's why a lot of gymnasts are very jacked in this region. And a really good movement that specifically targets the biceps is the pelican curl. Give that a shot. I'm not strong enough to do them, so you're not gonna see any B-roll from me. But check out my man Mechanimal or Fitness FAQs, or even Dan John Conditioning. All great guys with real info to provide. So rings, incline dumbbell curls, you can't go wrong. That's it, let's cover tries. What you want are movements which emphasize the long head, really give you that stretch, that deep pulling sensation. And the two best ways of doing this is either overhead extensions or off a flat or decline bench, but you're not bringing the bar to your forehead. Rather, it goes behind the head. And you can do this either by having your head at the edge of the bench or simply raising it up. You can perform whatever is most comfortable for you. But that's what gives you the stretch in the tries. Similar to a pullover motion, you wanna get your arms back. That feeling right there, similar to the old school stretch that you probably did in high school. This is what takes those mass gains to the next level. And for me personally, I prefer having back support, because when going overhead, I feel a little bit more in the shoulders, but not in a good way. So my preference is either flat or decline, but again, it doesn't really matter. As long as you're getting the stretch, you're good. And if you don't want to use free weights, in this case being dumbbells or an easy bar, that's typically what most people do, though it could be with a Swiss bar as well, then consider cables. You can adjust the angle, see what works best for you and your height. I would say a higher position is probably what you want to do, and there's different attachments for that. Again, it doesn't really matter so much. Obviously, the lateral on the medial head is extremely important for standard benching, and you'll get that with traditional extensions and regular tricep pushdowns, but if you want a bit more activation in that long head, it's all about the stretch. So find out which style works for you, or better yet, incorporate them all, and you really can't go wrong. So with that said, those are all the variations for weighted stretching. I want to know from you now, what are your favorite exercises? Give me your list. I'd love to hear feedback. So enjoy the gains, try out these exercises, and I'll see you in the next video.